integration of some type e to the power ax sin dx and integration of the type e to the power ax cos dx. Now I quickly derive the first one and then we can do the second one. So let's derive the first one. What is the answer for the, what is the integral for the first function? E to the power ax sin dx. Let's call it as I first. Now, you may choose any one of them as u, any one of them as v, because they are at the bottom of the layer 2. So which one you want to choose as u, which one you want to choose as v? Okay. U. Okay. So it's u times integral of e to the power ax, which is e to the power ax by a, minus derivative of sin bx, which is b cos bx, into e to the power ax by a. Okay? Take minus b by a common out. Now again apply integration by parts of this, taking this as v, taking this as u. So I becomes e to the power ax sin bx by a minus b by a. Now start applying integration by parts here. So u times integration of this will be e to the power ax by a minus derivative of u will be minus b cos bx minus b sin bx into e to the power ax by, correct? Now again pull out the factor of minus b by a out, it will become plus b by a. Now what is this term actually? I again. So I can say I is equal to e to the power ax sin bx by a minus, open the brackets, minus b by a square e to the power ax cos bx minus b square by a square I. Collect the i's at one place. So I times 1 plus b square by a square. Just to maintain consistency, can I write this as a and a square? So we can take the a square common denominator. So it is e to the power ax a sin bx minus b cos bx. Correct? Let's write this as a square plus b square whole divided by a square. A square, a square gets cancelled. So as a result, I becomes e to the power ax a sin bx minus b cos bx whole divided by a square plus b square. Please remember this result may be useful because in a bigger problem, you have to directly use such results. Similarly, please get the expression for the second integral e to the power ax cos bx. Now there is an alternate formula also to prove this. Let's say I call this integral as p. And I call this integral as q. Is that okay? Now if I ask you, what is p plus iq? I mean the imaginary iota. So what will your answer be? It will be e to the power ax cos bx plus I sin bx. Correct? Now if you are aware of or Euler substitution, cos dx plus I sin dx is actually e to the power I dx. Which is nothing but e to the power a plus ib. Correct? Yes, sir. Now this becomes quite easy to integrate. It becomes e to the power a plus ib x by a plus ib. And this is equal to p plus iq. Now we can quickly rationalize this first. So we can multiply this with a minus ib, which will make this as, what will happen to the denominator? A square plus b square. When you multiply a complex number with its conjugate, it becomes the square of the modulus. So this becomes a square plus b square. Okay. Now split this back again. I'm writing on the top. Split this back again as a minus ib by a square plus b square e to the power ax into e to the power ibx. Correct? And what is e to the power ibx? Cos bx plus I sin bx. Ultimately this is p plus iq. Okay. Now if I ask you, what is p and what is q from here? Can you find it out? P is the real part of it, right? What is the real part of it? What is the real part of it? How will you obtain the real part? When A multiplies with real part and IB multiplies with imaginary part. So can I say P will be the real part of this expression, which will be A into e to the power x, of course will be there, e to the power x. When this A multiplies to cos BX, and when this minus ib multiplies with I sin bx, which will be plus b sin bx. So p, which is actually this, is the result this? Check. Yes. Okay. Similarly, q will be what? Q will be the imaginary part. How would I get the imaginary part? If ib multiplies with this, or this multiplies with this. Correct? So imaginary part will be e to the power ax by a square plus b square. When a multiplies with this, you will get a sin bx. And when minus ib multiplies with this, you will get, of course I am not writing I because I can be taken common out. So this is iq. So this will be minus b cos bx. So basically q will be this, which is actually this. Okay, this is an alternate way to prove it. If you want, you can just follow this. That is called the Euler's formula. Euler said that e to the power I theta can be written as cos theta plus I sin theta. What is the proof for this? Okay, I'll prove it for you. Can I resist? It's just extra information, it's not like it's mandatory to know this, just an extra information. Okay. We all know z can be written as, if let's say I treat this as z. Okay. What is dz by d theta? Minus sin theta plus I cos theta. Okay. Now, take the factor of I out. If I take a factor of I out, will it not become this? And this term is what? Z. Correct? Now, can I write it like this? Dz by z, e equal to I d theta. Integrate. What will this become? Ln z. This will become I theta plus c. Okay. Now you know clearly from here, when theta is 0 degree, z is going to be 1. So put z as 1, theta as 0, you will get c also as 0. Because ln 1 is 0, I into 0 is 0, plus c. So 0 is equal to 0 plus c, so c will also be 0. Correct? If ln z is equal to I theta, z is equal to, so this can also be written as e to the power I theta. That's what Euler said. Okay. Anyways, remembering the result is more important. The derivation here is not that important for you, at least in your school tests. Can I erase this now? Let's take two questions based on this type. So I think there are too many formulas coming up that you need to keep in mind. Evaluate. Integral of sine of log x. And second is x square e to the power x sine x. First one is pretty easy, right?
Yes, sir.
So in the first question, substitute log x as t. So x becomes e to the power t. That means dx becomes e to the power t dt. So the entire problem converts as e to the power t sine t, which resembles that form. With x being replaced with t, a being replaced with 1, and b is replaced, b also replaced with 1. So the answer is going to be e to the power t by 2 sine t minus cos t. And
x by 2.
And t is going to be log of x, so e to the power log of x is x. So x by 2 sine of log x minus cos of log x. How about the second one?
Like, this is a really long bipartite question.
Yeah, yeah, it's a really long bipartite question. No, but you should do it. Simple to integrate because you already know the integration for this. I will call this as u. I will processing. Okay. There's another reason why we normally take the x squared as u is because you want that power to diminish as we proceed. So we have to differentiate. Okay. So according to integration by parts, its answer is going to be u times integral of this. Integral of this will be x by 2 sin x minus cos x. See, again, if I know the result, I'll be able to write it quickly. Okay.
The exam will have to do and then
what?
This formula.
So you can't have done this. Sir, they haven't done this in school.
There's no formula in it.
We haven't
done the formula. There is a question, but we have to solve it.
Not there is a formula. We have used integration but continuously with it. We haven't given them, we haven't made a formula.
That's not good. Can do it like?
That is giving the question.
Okay. Minus again, u,
v,
u,
and then there's another one inside that. It
needs to be plus.
So, are you?
Without this inside, plus is all plus.
No, no, it's not that. Now, apply integration by parts here. Okay. So this two I did here.
So you didn't need to split it. You could should you use either by x
and then sin x
as well as sin cos.
Can I? It has to be negative.
Minus cos.
Yeah.
We split it. You could just split it by itself.
You can take the minus one and then become that previous.
Any minus
minus cos.
So you
take minus out of full that and cos x
equals 7.
First step. So you get cos x minus sin x as
Oh, okay. I understood what you're saying. You're saying that this is easily integrable because it is of the form it is bar x f dash x. I mean, yeah.
But.
I'm an easy problem.
That's the next step.
Which step?
That step.
At this part, I am going to do what Rohan is saying. E to the power x. Can I say if I take this as my function, this will be the derivative of it? So what will be the result here? E to the power x into minus cos x. Correct? Now fine. What about this? Can I say if I say sin x is f, f of x, cos x will become f dash x? No, done. That's a problem is unanswered. Just expand, I mean, open the brackets later. Fine. Now moving on to integration of rational algebraic functions. Probably integration using partial fraction is the last thing you would have done in school in integration, right? Next is integration of rational algebraic functions using partial fractions. Now first of all, what is a rational algebraic function? Basically any function of the form polynomial by another polynomial is a rational function. Okay, this is called a